morning, Pips. Today is the 14th of June 2016. It's a Tuesday. It's 10:41 a.m. Last night it was cold. So today's video is about a mosque called Masjid Muhammadiyah or Muhammadiyah Mosque. It's in Tasik. It's an area in Ipoh. And it's also known as Chinese Mosque or Masjid China or Masjid China, according to this Google here, Google Maps. China is the country, of course, and Masjid China, without the H, C-I-N-A, that means Chinese. So it's a Chinese mosque. So from here, you can see from this south of this map here, look at the blue, I'll be going to the main road, which is Jalan Tasik here, and going up north, and it would be about 13 minutes ride, and it's only 6 kilometers away from me. So go 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 go, and here and here is here. Okay, it's here. This is Jalan Kuala Kangsar. And Jalan Kuala Kangsar you might be familiar with, because I've already done a journey to Jalan Kuala Kangsar via this highway here. In that video is like going to this temple called the Siamese Temple during the Vesak day to get some of the water which is endowed or imbued or is leveled up with chrysanthemum leaves. And Hari Vesak or Vesak day is Buddha's birthday, death day and enlightenment day all in one day. So see you at the Masjid China or Chinese mosque. So I'm gonna turn right at this traffic light here, turn right into Jalan Tasik. It used to be called Jalan Tasik, but now it's called Jalan Sultan Azlan Shah. So it's just a straight road going to that Chinese mosque. So if you go left from the main road, or this is the main road, you go left, you end up in the North and South Highway and stuff. So just go straight up and whatever. This is Kinta Shopping Complex or Aeon Ipoh Garden. Aeon Ipoh Garden. So traffic light, turn right, go straight all the way. Masjid China is on the right, blocked by houses and also shopping lots. This is the same main road. So traffic light here, turn right, and there will be a sign there that says Masjid Muhammadin. You can see that sign there, blocked by the lorries, of course. That one, Masjid Muhammadin. There's an Indomie factory. Coincidentally, I made a video about the Indomie food, and there is a pagoda there behind the trees there. You should be able to see it. This is a market here. Yep, or Medan Selera, this restaurant. And just now the traffic light, I was there. The traffic light is there. This is the Medan Selera, or the place where you can buy some food. It smells bad here, unfortunately. I'm not sure what that is. I think there's a room for rubbish collection. And that's the Masjid China or Masjid Muhammadiyah, as the sign says there. Oh, there's some food cooking somewhere. Smells great. So maybe I'll go and take a looky at the place. So it's on Jalan Musim Bunga, or Musim Bunga is, I think, means summer or no, spring, sorry. Musim Bunga is spring. So this is a 360 view of the place. There are a lot of factory workers because of the Indomie factory that makes instant noodles. Indomie is a company that makes instant noodles. Let's park my bike somewhere around, I'm not sure. So I'm at the parking space or parking lot. A lot of parking space for cars, but I don't see any parking space for motorcycles. Therefore, I park my motorcycle here under the shade next to a bougainvillea plant, and that plant that produces white flowers, and that's the pagoda. Or the, I think maybe the they put speakers there to make it very loud during their prayers. Six prayers or five prayers a day. A bamboo tree there, there's a kelapa sawit or an oil palm tree. Yeah, definitely is an oil palm tree. So this is one side of the mosque, the Chinese mosque. So let's go and head towards that way. The architecture of the building here, which is facing the main road, not the main road, the big road, this is a bamboo tree, is quite interesting. It's new, of course. It's they spend a lot of money, the government, on this mosque. So it's not a really old structure. It's not as old as San Po Tong Temple or any other Chinese temples in Ipoh. Okay, it took me 15 minutes to come here, 16 minutes from where I live. So there's the sign there, Masjid Muhammadiyah. And you can see there's a placard here. This is also very new. If it was very old, that means it would be made of granite or carved in stone. But this is metal and cheap stuff, of course. And my god, it's around 11:13 a.m. It's 14th of June 2016. It's a Tuesday. It's 37 degrees Celsius according to my watch, which includes the heat that was produced by, I mean, is produced by my body. If I say it was produced, that means was produced by my body, that means I'm dead, or currently the person who's talking to you is the voice coming from a dead body. So grammar is very important, and that's why my grammar sucks, so careful. So wow, the sun is so terrible. It's hot, very very hot indeed. It's, if you want to be in Malaysia, you want to visit you want to go and explore the culture of Malaysia, make sure you do it before 11 a.m. Now it's already 11:15 a.m. and it's bloody hot. It's beating down on you. And of course, okay, let's go inside, I think. Or maybe walk around the perimeter. Oh shit, I can't go in with my Bermuda pants. They have a strict fuck. Okay. God damn it. Don't make a lot of noise. That means I make a lot of noise. You're talking and stuff. Maybe I just walk in there and make sure my Bermuda pants are a bit lower than usual. Lower it until it covers the kneecaps and whatnot. So according to the wiki or some Eli or explain it like I'm five, it says that it is very hot and humid and uncomfortable because it's very humid. The area is very humid. If you want to cool down your body, it needs to be able to leave your body easily. So if the atmosphere is very humid, it's hard for the sweat to leave your body. And if it's very hard for it to leave your body, the sweat, it will be hard for it to cool down your body. So the humidity of the area that you are residing in or live in is important. That's why if it was like, a lot of people say that in Japan during the summer it's very hot. That means it is very very humid there. So it's not that big. It's from there to there, so it's not super huge. Look at the roof. It's made of porcelain and the architecture is very Chinese like. You can see it's orange in color and also green at the sides of the place. Very cool indeed, very cool. With some bougainvillea motif or whatchamacallit, flowers, tiles up there, bougainvillea. That's the national flower of Malaysia. So it's Ramadan, that means the Muslim people are fasting. So don't drink or eat in front of them from 6 a.m. or from sunrise to sunset. Yeah, it's disrespectful, it seems, if you do that on Ramadan day. Because in 1 month's time, they'll be celebrating their Hari Raya. So Chinese people, they love bonsai trees. So this is a bonsai tree. The leaves are not that small, but it's a good effort. And I'm not sure whether I should leave my shoes here. It's quite expensive, my shoes actually. Tanggal kasut kat sini ke? I'm not sure actually. So I'm gonna leave my shoes here. And let's go around looking at the place. They're supposed to put the shoes here instead. I think, I'm not sure actually. Who knows? So Chinese, tempat letak kasut. So they put your shoes here. So let's see here. Keep quiet. They pray around here. This open whatever space, gazebo. And my bike is next to the palm tree here. So there's more bonsai trees. And there's a safe there. Why is there a safe? No idea. So let's go and take a look inside. They are vacuuming the place. And let's go and see the architecture. It's locked. Never mind. Should I go through the front? Okay. So this is the... So this is where they wash themselves. They have to wash themselves first before they pray to the God. So very important to clean oneself. You don't need to take a shower. All you need to do is clean your hands, your feet and your face. Some water here. And again, do not drink when there's sun up in the sky. If the sun is visible, because it's Ramadan. I wish the premise would be, the temple or mosque would be older than this, but this structure is very, very new. Are there, and like shopping complexes in Ipoh, there is the obligatory pay for the massage chair thing, and some toilets here, and the mosque's office is there, and food at the back there for when they want to break their fast around 7 p.m. Every day is a different time for breaking fast. Depends on the visibility of the sun. Sometimes the sun is not, when the sun is no longer visible, it's already in the horizon, and that's the time to chomp chomp. And a motif here, look at this, it's green, it's red, and it's Chinesey. You get caught up in the architecture, which is pretty new, and I wonder if my Adidas shoes are still there or not. There's another rack for not a woman's rack, but a rack for the shoe. And there's a plane there with condensation trails emanating from the tips of its wings. Contrails, they call it. So contrails means condensation trails. And that's a typical, we call, neighborhood or houses for normal people to live in. At the back of the mosque, must be terrible. It must be quite an inconvenience to live near a mosque, because it's very, very noisy around 5 a.m. especially when they're living so close to the mosque. So you get an automatic alarm clock. This must be the woman's toilet. So yum yum. So you can wash your body here or your feet here. So there are Muslim people here that who are not from Malaysia, of course. They are making food. This is there's a stage there, a small stage, and protect the. There's a big gazebo or a rooftop here. Lights, ceiling fan. This is to break their fast around 7 p.m. So I think there's nothing much else to see, unless I want to take a tour of the women's toilet, which I'm not going to do that. Oh, some coconut trees. Oh my god, big, lots of coconuts. I love coconuts. Oh, coconut tree. I love to eat you now. Fuck, man. Just walking around with small little pebbles everywhere. It's not comfortable. It's quite a small mosque, I can say. I think I just have to go to the toilet and see, and relieve myself of my yellow liquid. Make water, as they like to say during olden times. So there's another place here where you can wash yourself, your legs, and they provide you with seats, which a lot of mosques, they do not provide that. You have to stand up and hopefully you have to do like so to wash the soles of your feet, and maybe you slip and fall and break your neck. That's scary. So with the addition of seats around, it would be much safer and better and more comfortable, especially for the old people who still go to the mosque. What am I saying? The old people always go to the mosque because they have nothing to do since they're retired or not doing anything. So this is a new main door with all this Chinese design, and people here living here, Chinese people who are not Muslims. And you think that this mosque, Chinese mosque, means there are a lot of Chinese coming here? No, it's just the Malays. The Malays going to a mosque that seems very alien and very Chinesey. There are not many Muslim Chinese in Malaysia, unless they are smart enough to become, or the Chinese people are smart enough to become Muslims and try to get some extra dough from the government, because the government is really pro-Muslim or pro-Islam. So you get a lot of benefits from being of one faith over another. So there's a nice looking fountain, man-made of course, lotus plant there. Lotus plants are ubiquitous in Chinese temples, which has ponds in it, which have ponds in it, I think. So I think that's about it. Actually, there's nothing else to say. This video has been going on for too long. So, yep, small little mosque. Hopefully, you did not get sick from me wobbling around and the camcorder going everywhere. And this is the main hall, so there are more men around obviously, and the women are not supposed to pray with the men, so unfortunately you cannot like spy on the female prostrating like that man there and seeing their nice big ass and the imaginary vagina. Oh, fuck, I should not be saying that. This is the area that segregate the female prayers in some other place, because men and male and females do not mix properly, and therefore it's quite a volatile mix. They separate both of these mixes. So the females, like in all cultures, they are denigrated into a smaller section of the society. Big area for men and open, of course. Females, small area and enclosed. So yep, females are being used and also of course being denigrated, or has a smaller role to play according to the, or from the perspective of males everywhere. I would like females to be more commanding and more dominatrixy, so that they can whip me and pleasure me, and this cat is quite enticing. Pussy. Of course, it's a what do you call it? It's not a wild cat. It has been humanized, and not humanized.
it has been around humans, so it's not afraid of us slaughtering it for meat at all. Hey, hello? Hello, what you doing?
Pussy,
what are you doing? You're smelling the wall. Why? Is it because of the paint? Is it giving you a high? Better than cannabis? Who knows? So that's for the females going up there. And the guy is using handphone, of course. And of course, since it's praying that way, that means the hijra, not hijra, the black box in Saudi Arabia is that way. So they always have to pray that way. Can I actually wear socks on? Never mind. Let's go and see. It's a nice design. It's like a pillar of the olden days. Cool. It's on fire too. Either that's fire or it might be some kind of thorns. Who knows? So let's go and take a look. If it's not locked, it's locked. Fuck. So look up there. It's quite cool. And of course those writings there on the wall, they are called squibby squibbly. No, it's called Jaubi, I think it's called in Malaysia, but I think it's called something else in other countries. But here in Malaysia, it's called Jaubi. Nothing to do with Jawa. Jawa is a island in Indonesia, and also can be called Mee Jawa, which is Jawa noodles, which is quite nice. And it's made of the gravy is made of sweet potato and all types of spices. Yummy, yummy. I'm hungry now. And it's only 11:30 a.m. Oh, that's me. Cool. So, that's about it. Toilet break. And chow chow. Okay, my shoes are still there. Thank God. There's a hitchhiker in my socks. Hitchhiker means a small little pebble or a rock. And of course, a real human hitchhiker is a person who do a thumbs sideways to hitch a ride, therefore hitchhiker. Cool, eh? English is lovely, but can be quite complicated, especially when you have a brain damage like I have. So slippers, lovely. I have to sit down actually. Oh, there are ants everywhere. Are they red or black? Red ones are scary as fuck. So I'm gonna sit down and relax. And this place really reminds me of the toilets in or next to the highway. Okay, there goes that stupid hitchhiker. Goddamn pebble. Quite small but irritating. It's like a thorn. Thorn between the legs. Wait, what? Thorn between the legs? What does that mean? Does that mean females? That's called a gash or a slit. Or fuck, I should not be saying that. So, wash my face and ciao ciao. So everything here is very very new. Look at the metal roof of the toilet. So, there are showers as well. Oh, I'm tempted to actually take this home. But never mind. Do not steal when you are in a religious place. So again, very nice. Very nice indeed. Somebody is using the massage chair. You have to put some coins into it. So this is the pillar or something. Can you actually go up? Yeah, there's a ladder in there. So that concludes my review of the place. It's quite okay. Quite new, very new, very 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 new indeed. I want to drink water actually. But it's a sneak. Water on a hot day. Nice. So yep, this is the Chinese mosque. If I've offended you with my remarks, I'm sorry. It was all done in jest. So to sometimes when it comes to religious things, it's better not to joke around because you can get lynched and killed and whatever. You're living in some place like Pakistan, which is terrible if you're living there. So nice place indeed. And smell curry. Oof, I'm hungry now. I'm really hungry. So this is one of the attractions of Ipoh. One of them. Ipoh is famous for more like Chinese temples, and this is a Chinese Chinese mosque. So I'm going to go there, and maybe if I see a lot of people eating somewhere or patronizing a hawker store or whatever, then I'll stop and eat, because it's 11:30 a.m. still early. So see you later. Help me in making the next video by supporting me through Patreon. Thank you very much, and bye bye.